this is supposed to be this lookout road, and this is as far as it goes. So I think this is it. Hey guys, thanks for joining us today. We're out following the Karua River. This is the Monkeroy Bridge. Going to head out towards Riverwood Downs and Monkeroy, even up towards the upper Karua River. Couple of places to go, places to see. We're going to go and check it out. Join us for a quick blast out in the mountains.
And we'll go and venture out to a couple little places that I've been hanging out to get out to for a while. Now, this bridge was flooded last time I came through here. Oh, how nice is that? Look at it. Beautiful. What a great way to start. Water's flowing. Yep, totally in love with this area. All right, let's carry on. Let's go for a hoot.
All right, so Riverwood Downs. One of the lads at work went down here recently with some mates. Did a bit of camping. Here are cabins, function centre. Let's go and have a look, see what it's like, see what's out there. Whew. Function area, and I take it reception's down here as well somewhere. Cleaners are getting stuck into it. There's a swimming pool. Beautiful area, look at that. Okay. Big fire pit, picnic area. Water's just down the hill. And there's your cabins. So this must be some of the camping area. We'll have to have a look on the website to have a good look at it. But you got camp areas there. And then the cabins. These cabins look beautiful. All right, well this could be a bit of fun. And that's your camping area. All right, well, I'm quite keen to come and check this place out. I think we'll have to do a test on the camping area out here at Riverwood Downs. Beautiful spot. Try not to bend the bike while we're here. Yeah, gorgeous spot. Okay, we'll give it a shot at some stage or another. We'll carry on and see what the GPS says. Let's see how the rest of the run goes today. Cool, on we go. Wow, that's pretty cool. I like it. That's nice. Awesome. All right. Up we go.
Great roads out here. Look at that mountain range. So we're just south of Gloucester. You can see that nice mountain range sitting out in front there. Is one that you see coming up Buckets Road. Unfortunately, Buckets is completely full of roadworks. So it was a struggle getting up here earlier today. Oh wow, look at that. Beautiful house just sitting in here. Wouldn't be bloody awesome waking up to this every morning. Really keen to get out to Hill End with a great bunch of lads coming up in the next couple of weeks. We'll definitely be getting some footage. Be nice to be able to get out with a few guys again. A good bunch as well. We'll watch out for the cattle. Looks like this is cattle country. and they could be mucking around out here on the road, so we'll just we'll just go easy. It's dusty too. And of course we had more rain recently. Actually the temperatures have been getting cold. So we're at the end of May, and three mornings in a row at home, it got down to 2 degrees. Coldest was, I think, 1.4. Very, very frosty mornings. I've been looking forward to taking the bike in, riding into work, but yeah, it's been a bit cold. I might have to do one of those ultimate cold tests with the Kamini gear. Layer up and throw it all on over the uniform and see if I can survive the 40 minute run to work in the frosty temperatures. I have all confidence, in all honesty, in being able to do that. Well, we're gaining some altitude here. Slippery boards. What is that? Not only some altitude but some views as well. Lovely. And to think I've got to come back this way as well. Oh, what a bugger. I wonder what's up here. So this is the Upper Karoo River. Complete temperature change. And the scenery is spectacular. Wow. Right in the valley down here, you could feel the cold. So this is as far as the Google car got, by the looks of it. Private properties around here. Now that's Crown land, how about that? Which means it'll be, it's not going to be maintained, and I'm certainly not going to take myself up that. See if your trailies have been up there as well. I'm happy to bust it around here and just have a quick look. Let's see what's down this way. So I've still got a fair bit of, a couple of areas I still want to venture out to, right next to this gorgeous house. Oh, this is beautiful. Well, it's as far as we can get up the Upper Karoo. There's no need trying to get up there. There's nothing out that way. I'm going to start making my way back and find out where Google's going to take us next. Oh, a bit of road work again. Well, come, that might not be a good sign, you know. Oh yeah, they've had a slip through here recently by the looks of it. Trying to patch it all up. Oh yeah, that's pretty big. Ooh, it wants me to go up there. You know, I think I'll give it a run. Just see what it's like. Come on. It's not really rutted. It's rocky. Oh, it's actually not bad. Just watch ahead, though. Only supposed to be a short distance up. Remember, I still got to come down it too. That's always a challenge. Funny how you don't think about that until you're halfway up. Nice one, Bullfed. Have I told you guys about the 430 track? I'm sure I've said it in one of my previous videos, but to give you an idea, the wife and I, many years ago, back in the day when we had a Land Cruiser, we were kicking around, having a ball, went out to some places, had a picnic. It was really nice. And on the way home, you know, you're still feeling like you want to do a little bit more. And it's about that 4:30. It was summer, so it was all right. Peeled off to this little track, thought we'd have a look. Well, this little track wasn't a track at all. It was actually a foot and a half deep mud, very, very soft mud. So you know what it's like with a big, heavy Land Cruiser, buried down to the axles. And a very good mate of mine, Dave, who also has a Land Cruiser, well, he just finished washing his cruiser that day, and I begged him to come and pull me out, and that man came to my rescue. I'm going to put a link to his channel, because he's still out and about doing some stuff. He's still got some photos of our off-road days, and he's doing really well. He's a big Monaro fan. So have a quick look at that if you want to check that one out. But this track here is reminding me of that there 430 track. Now it feels solid. No one's been up here for a while. But you know, anything can happen, right? So let's see what's up. This is supposed to be this lookout road. And this is as far as it goes. So I think this is it. There isn't even a track here, look at it. All right, that's as far as this will go now. Let's see if I've got a turnaround spot up here somewhere. Geez, if I wanted some firewood, I could have just come up here, couldn't I? But this is the end game. Holy crap, look at this. It's going to be good. Bit of rock, bit of this, bit of that. Take it real easy on the way down. Woo. What a great spot. Definitely time to rock and roll now, being 20 past two. Yeah. Geez, I'm a bit knackered. It was good to have a quick bite to eat. And then, bit of a stick, there we go. Might to eat some water, recoup, and carry on. Down to Moncrow Road. And well away from that edge. I love this bike. She's so good to me. Downhill again. Midges everywhere. Campsite. Nice. Get away from the edge. We're right on the top of the mountain there. It's just swapped over. if you've got that envy of doing something like this and you're concerned about lack of skill or experience, I take a leaf out of my book, go and do it. I'm learning, but I've learned so much recently by going out with great people, soaking up knowledge of other people. This will be the best thing that you ever do, seriously. Look at that. And now we're on the main road. That was fun. Well, a little bit proud of myself there. Yeah, if you're sitting back watching these videos thinking, oh, I wonder, go and do it. Just go and do it. Because seriously, it's brilliant. I love it. I've had a number of people ask me, you know, about the Africa Twin, like the weight and what I do. Look, even though I haven't had any experience in the past, I've rapidly grown to get used to the weight of this bike, and it's only when you're going slow. Like at the moment, I don't feel the weight in this bike right now, and you just got to be careful of where you go. Just be wary of it, because this is a great bike. You might end up, you know, these are the tracks that I love doing, and that thing up Lookout Road, that was pretty good. You know, that was good fun. It was confident, you know, and that confidence has grown in me only because of the people that I've been able to ride with and talk to and you know, and get to know. It's a nice area. You can certainly get out on a bike like the Africa Twin and do that, because the other thing I don't want to miss out on is my road touring. I'm thinking about doing another run up to Merriwall, where the silos are, the painted silos, coloured silo art, that's it, silo art. And I never got a chance to go to the pub up at Merriwall. I also want to go and do Bylong Valley Way again, now that's been sorted out. So I've got all these areas to go to. And look, it can be done on a, you know, KTM, the 790, the 980, anything like that. I just prefer the Twin. Yes, it's a bit heavier, got longer range, that's for sure. The 24 litre tank is outstanding. It's one thing I love with the GS, having, you know, 20 litres, but that extra 4 litres goes a long way. You know, if you're looking at the difference between a GS and an Africa Twin, from my personal experience, I have found a big difference with the 21-inch front compared to the 19. But the GS on road and on stuff like this is an outstanding bike as well. You know, BMW do a fantastic bike. I couldn't justify that servicing cost and all those bits and pieces. But again, this is what I love. I love this AT. The Adventure Sports is definitely well worth spending the extra money. Got the DCT, that's definitely well worth it. That's a game changer when it comes to riding. And I think that is the only reason, well now the second reason, as to why I haven't dropped the bike, because I've been using the DCT and I haven't had to focus on gear changes, stalling, going slow, doing silly things like that. So I'm in a pretty lucky position, and I reckon you could do that too. If you think this is something that you'd really enjoy and you're just concerned about the you know, the weight, don't be. Seriously, don't be. Start slow, start easy, do some courses, go out with people. Look, if you're local to Newcastle, come out with me. Come and do some of these roads and come and have a bit of fun. Just throw a message down below and we'll tee it up. You know, I get a lot of days off during the week, and this is the perfect time to ride, because there's next to no traffic. Weekends are a bit hard for me, got the family, and that's the priority. My little man and I love spending a lot of time together, and it's only on very special occasions I get out on a weekend. But yeah, during the week, if you want to come for a blast during the week, let's tee it up. Anyhow, well, we're going to do a little bit more of this later on. I hope you enjoyed this. There's plenty of these roads to explore in my backyard, so I hope you're keen to see them, because there's going to be a lot of it.